In English, when you're reading something, have you ever come across certain words or phrases or clauses that simply don't make sense? I mean, if I were to say that I were over the moon because I got a 10 on 10 in my test, would that actually mean that I went all the way over the moon? No, right? That doesn't make any sense. So what are these phrases that say one thing according to their words and actually mean something completely different? In English, such phrases or words are called idioms. Now, idioms are phrases which mean one thing according to the words they have, but they actually have a different meaning when it's taken as a unit. So, for instance, these idioms here we have different meanings. So, if I say over the moon, it actually means I'm very happy. Now, here we have once in a blue moon, which tells me something happens very rarely. So if I say she comes here once in a blue moon, that would mean that she comes here very rarely or not often at all. So even though it's written with the words blue moon, it doesn't really mean that it happens once every time there is a blue moon. So that wouldn't make any sense. So idioms need to be taken care of because you shouldn't take it literally, or you shouldn't take the meaning as being exactly how the words are placed or what the words convey directly. If you can identify that a particular phrase is an idiom, then it becomes a lot easier if you recognize it to understand what it means in the sentence. So whenever you come across such phrases which simply don't make sense, such as these ones over here, then you write them down, write down what they mean, find out what their meaning is in and from online sources or in an idiom dictionary, etc. Or ask someone that knows these phrases and then make sure that you remember those meanings so that you can use them in your own writing or you can recognize them and understand their meaning when they come across. Now, although this makes understanding a lot more difficult, especially when you don't know the meaning of the most common idioms, it's important, therefore, to go through the most important or most common idioms that you can come across in the English language. And these are some of them. So here we have the next one, cut to the chase. So cut to the chase doesn't mean that you're cutting the chase. It means that leave out the unnecessary details and tell me the main point. So if I tell you to cut to the chase and give me the records of the previous year, then it means that I don't want to hear anything else. I just want to know what I require right now. So next one is piece of cake. You must have heard this. Piece of cake is very commonly used to mean that it's very easy. It doesn't mean that I'm asking for a piece of cake. It means that something is quite easy to do. So if I say that this sum is a piece of cake, then I'm saying that the sum is easy to solve or it's very easy for me to solve. Next we have go the extra mile. Go the extra mile means you don't have to run the extra mile. It means doing more than what is required or putting in extra effort to get something done or to get something achieved, right? Next we have blessing in disguise. What this means is that it could be something unexpected which turns out to be something good. So it's something advantageous or something positive that was unexpected. So it was a blessing in disguise. So you can say that the exam being postponed was a blessing in disguise, or you can say not passing the test was a blessing in disguise because had I passed the test, my parents would have sent me off to a boarding school, etc., etc. So you can come up with ways that you can use these idioms. Making use of idioms in your own writing really helps convey that you understand their meanings and that you are slightly advanced in your understanding of the language. So it can really help improve the way people take you as a writer. So if you are writing an essay or if you're writing a report or any article, then using idioms can really help give you a style in your writing, can help you convey that you know the meaning of these idioms and you are making use of them. So there are many, many, many idioms that you have in English. So go ahead and how about you do your homework today? Get a couple of idioms. If you like them, note them down, look at their meanings, and make sure that you use them in your writing. Explore more about the topics you love with Toppr. Subscribe now and keep learning.